The year 2012 ended on a tragic note with a gruesome gang rape case in the nation's capital. Atrocities against women in the country are on the rise these days. Even though they existed in older times, their magnitude, frequency, and severity have reached unprecedented proportions. 2000 years ago, Jesus taught us, love thy neighbor as thyself. But what is happening around us today is just the opposite. Violence like rape and murder, exploitation, inequality, do we see in our society? All our claims to being civilized amount to mere affectations. So much has been preached, taught, and written about compassion, kindness, and truth, all to little avail. The more our society is becoming civilized and advanced, the greater it is becoming vulnerable to all kinds of disruptive and violent developments. The incident in the capital, no doubt, unleashed an uprising of the youth in protest against heinous crimes. The Indian women continue to be treated as an unwanted subhuman species in our country. Adherence to rotten practices like female feticide, abortion, dowry, and depriving the young girl child of good food and nutrition, education, and health care are only a few examples. A nation that kills its own children has no future, said the late legendary Pope John Paul II in 1996. We take pride in the fact that we are a progressive nation. We are proud of our democracy and of our secular values. But we turn a blind eye and deaf ear to the injustices and inequalities that prevail in our society, especially in the case of women. Our attitude of simultaneously worshipping and denigrating women must change. Rape is not the only form of violence practiced against women. We must change our patriarchal and disrespectful attitude towards women. We as a nation have to go a long way in our treatment of our own women. Punishing the culprits is not going to be the only effective deterrent. Sensitizing people on the issue is the way to go about. Society, especially adolescents and youth, need to be taught about the rightful place of women in the society. They should also be enlightened on sexual discrimination, harassment, assault, and rape. Laws alone will be grossly inadequate for changing the culture of caste inequality, corruption, or violence against women. Helping people to change their mindsets will see an abiding change. The significance of the Delhi incident is that it could draw attention to the poor, social, economic, political, judicial, and administrative situation existing in our country. We must take a larger view of the social restlessness, lawlessness, intimidation, and violence. While joining the sea of protesters in condemning the heinous crime and demanding adequate punishment for the culprits, we, the Chai family, reiterate our resolve to devote more time and resources to empower more and more women and girl children to fight the discrimination and inequalities shown to them. The Catholic Health Association of India, being an organization of religious sisters, has been focusing on the health of women, children, and elderly for the past 7 decades. CHAI has an expansive base of 3,300 member institutions, including large, medium, as well as small hospitals, health centers, and social service societies. Its massive network comprises 11 regional units, 1,000 sister doctors, 25,000 sister nurses, and 10,000 paraprofessionals. Every year, around 21 million people access the healthcare facilities provided by CHAI's member institutions. In the future, we would intensify our efforts at changing the mindsets of people, especially youth, through moral education and awareness building. CHAI recommits itself to better the future of every girl child and woman in the country through interventions in health and health education. May God bless our efforts.